All right, your question, where did God come from, assumes that you're thinking of the wrong, obviously it displays that you're thinking of the wrong God, because the God of the Bible is not affected by time, space, or matter. If he's affected by time, space, or matter, he's not God. So for, and the concept that a spiritual force cannot have any effect on a material body, well then I guess you'd have to explain to me things like emotions and love and hatred and envy and jealousy and rationality. I mean, if your brain is just a random collection of chemicals that formed by chance over billions of years, how on earth can you trust your own reasoning processes and the thoughts that you think.
Many misconceptions today when it comes to the mighty Son. People thinking that he forgave our sins and nothing else to it. It is done. Well, yeah, it's done. He said it's done. But there's more to it than what you're giving it. Don't simplify it and make it less than what you want to imply it. Rather apply it. Sugarcoating the story to make it fun and redeeming. But when it comes to what he went through, it's actually defeating. Dying for our sins ain't something that can be easily understood. Many of us can have stood and taken the beating while others stood and laughed while he stood his ground. You really want to know what it means to die for people and take the sins? Well, better strap up, cause it's gonna take more than your common sense. Your common sense is what made you believe the story's worth as much as a pocket full of sense. The Son of God himself took your sins. How does that make sense?
You don't know. Nah. You don't know. You don't know.
Just stop and think about that place he took on the cross, taking the nails and crown for all the death to be lost. But wait a minute, think about it. Whose place did he take on that cross? Ah, that's right, we deserve that place, but he took it when death was rightfully ours. Why do that? Why do that for someone who put you through that? Well, because he understood the long run of the act and what that would mean for us in the end. God loved us so much that he wanted us to receive eternal life, but doing so required the blood of his Son to be shed instead of ours. How does that make sense?
You don't know. You don't know. Nah, you don't know.
Moving on to the next part that you must understand. The fact that you want God to stand under you when in fact he stood under you, so that you could be higher than you were, cause you were so deep in debt that you were able to breathe in it, while others were suffocating on debt that they wanted deliverance. Jesus died for me, so I'm a prince. Don't be proud, it's more than that. Ever since the Son of God came down and took your sins, so go and sin no more. He said his death for us was just by chance. He died so that we could be better than this. Now does that make sense?
Now you know. Yeah. Now you know. Now you know. Yeah. Now you know.
Space or matter. If I could fit the infinite God in my 3-pound brain, he would not be worth worshiping. That's for certain. So that's the God that I worship. Thank you.